でしょ。Don't have enough income. And I said, oh my goodness, let me go in here and talk to them. So I goes in their office and I talk to them. I said, look, this woman is homeless. I'm just helping her out, but I have to go. I can't help her out. She's gonna be stuck here with y'all in front of y'all place. Maybe y'all can give her a place to stay for 30 days and maybe she'll have more income. Or maybe she'll just have to find another place to stay. And the lady said, no, I'm sorry, we can't help her. No, we can't do that. And the lady, I'm looking at the lady, she's looking all sad and everything. And I'm saying, oh my God, Lord, why would you do this to me? Why? And then I was like, oh my God, I was like, okay. I put her stuff back into my car. She sat into the seat and I'm just looking at her like, and she about crying. And I said, well, it's still kind of early. Let's just go around as many places as we can to see if we can find you an apartment. And they will accept what you have, you know? And she said, really? I said, well, I don't have no choice unless I leave you here. And she says, no, no, please help me. Please help me. So I called my friend. Now, I'm going to be honest. I called him on speakerphone on purpose because I just wanted him to understand that I was helping this woman out and that I was going to be there as soon as I can. Now, I assumed when I called him, everything was going to be okay, you know, because the guy really liked me and I like him. He answers the phone. He says, hey, where you at? Where you at? And I said, I'm not in the area right now. I said, listen, I have someone with me, and it's a woman that I picked up. She needed a ride. She needed some help. So I took her to the location she needed to go to, and the apartment, they said that she can't have it because she don't have enough income. He said, wait a minute, hold up.
Veggie burger. It's about hot boca. And I think the hot dog, I think it's called Smart Veggie Hot Dogs. I had to go all the way to Fiesta to find them. Oh my God, these chips are good. It's like, I just want to sit here and just eat the chips. You know, that's the feeling I got. They're really good. Okay, so my daughter bought a new car. Because we had a lot of issues with the car that drove down here to Texas, because when we left Virginia, my daughter and son, my daughter had just learned how to drive, but she drove another car. We had two Saturdays.
a lot is going on. I'm just watching people being nosy. That I was on these prescription meds. And every time I would meet up with him, I just could not bring myself to tell him what I was dealing with. We got closer and we got closer. And then one day I decided, you know, this man been really, really good to me. I'm going to do something really special.
Instead of going out to cook,
I'm going to bring my grill. I will buy the groceries and I will buy a nice bottle of dinner wine. And I'm going to come and cook for him. So I went and bought
fresh fish,
corn on the cob, some broccoli.
He lighted some rice.
Incense, and it smelled so good. And we just listened to music. He helped me cook. And it was, I just had the best time ever. I really enjoyed cooking for this person. And oh my goodness, he said, "Spirit, why didn't you tell me you can cook?" And he says, "Oh my goodness, what I'm gonna do? Cause I don't wanna eat your food all the time."
Yeah,
he enjoyed my
one particular
cooking.
Day.
He called me, and he said, "Hey, are you available on Sunday?" He says,
and
"Well,
I
want to
spend
the whole entire day with you. I just want us to really, really have a really,
leave
really
this story
time.
With this."
When Sunday came, I got ready for that date. I was excited for that date. But then when I walked outside, it was a woman at
my gate.
And she said, "Excuse me, excuse me." And I was just rushing,
trying to get to the car.
And she says, "Ma'am, can you give me a ride?"
To wish you love and light. I hope that you're having a wonderful, wonderful day. Or you just relax. I'm trying to stay calm, you know what I'm saying? Slept around and was just with so many men that Jen thought that Shani was gonna believe it, or she thought somebody would tell Shani and Shani will believe it. That's what she thought. And oh my God, I'm just
and it's crazy because Evelyn, she's so focused on trying to get Johnny to get rid of Damon that I almost feel like she won what Jen did to just blow over. That's what I feel like. And oh my God, it's, I don't know. It's some secrets being held. Got so much going on for her. She's gonna quit. Get myself together. So once I have my baby, I wasn't gonna be dealing too much with him anyway. I'ma move up sometime. And during this time, I was about 9 months pregnant and some change. On my daughter's birthday came up, my oldest daughter. It's going on 7. At her birthday, she was turning 7. Actually, she was turning 7. And he came around and he asked me, could he take my daughter for a carnival for her birthday. So, me being a mom and my daughter had little friends. And mind you, I was pregnant. Now, my baby father came by and picked us up, and was on our way to Coney Island for my daughter's birthday because we had planned like a small get together with her friends and for her birthday at Coney Island, and everything was like a really normal day. My daughter was really happy. The kids was happy, but it was hard, like keeping up with them, because I remember feeling so freaking tired. Like, I was young, so I still pretty much had energy. But that particular day, I start feeling like, oh my God, I'm exhausted. Like, I was really, really exhausted.
Found this place in the heart of Midlothian City. It was so nice. It was like in one of those little small shopping centers where it was like a community where everybody got to know each other. I was so excited because there was no flower shop near the location at all. So I had a good opportunity to really get back. Got makeup in my hair. I normally don't do that, but okay. And the neighborhood that the location was in was kind of a upscale type neighborhood. So it's really, really nice. And I was lucky because the space that they were renting was the smallest space in debt.
Self-feed. All of them. Oh my God, the baby food is expensive.
I do not exercise. Indonesia. That's the only thing I think I understand.
that. This is down real good.